So this is going to be a reading for my Sagittarius. Welcome back to my channel and welcome all my new Sagges. This is going to be urgent messages from your spirit guides. Let's jump straight in. I love this deck that I'm using today. It's a little different. Let me move all this stuff off the thing because what the heck. I love this deck. I've been bonding with it. It's super accurate. It's super straight to the point. So let's see what comes up. Sag, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements. Ooh, we have the fish. We have the tree. Sag, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements. We have the star. The coffin. We have the mountain and the moon. The anchor, the stork, and birds. All right, and then let's pull four cards from here, and then let's really dive deep in terms of the cards that are down here, okay? Sag, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus placements. What are the urgent messages from their spiritual team? All right, so we have every journey begins with a first small step. Don't let past events color your vision for the future. Have confidence that you can make progress. Give your creativity the space it needs to flourish. So I'm getting two distinctive messages with the Oracle cards. I'm getting one message where when it comes to creative endeavors, especially when it comes to talents that you have, it's important that you don't just give up or decide that you're just going to quit before even taking that first step, okay? Every journey literally starts with that first step, whether that's, you know, creating that Instagram, creating that YouTube for, you know, your creativity, or just taking that first step in terms of showing up for yourself every single day in general is what's necessary. Now, another message I'm picking up on too is that you guys could be letting the past have you in a chokehold. And the worst thing that you could do is focus so much on everything else but the present moment. Where are you losing opportunity in the present because you're worried about how 2 months from now is going to turn out in your love life, in your finances, etc., instead of creating that outcome you want to see 2 months from now. Now, going deeper into the energy that we have here, like I said, we have the fish. The fish usually represents abundance, opportunity. Okay, there's plenty of fish in the sea. All right, and for some of my Sagges, you literally will have plenty of love options literally show up at your doorstep. There could be people who are like just hitting you up on Instagram because you're posting more, or you have like certain people who know that you're single now and now they want in, now they want your attention. Okay, this also could be the energy of like alcohol and like over consuming of alcohol. So you do need to be careful of like substance abuse and all of that. But this is abundance. This is earnings. This is like assets. Like I said, budgeting, funds, like money, things being in circulation, things moving. And with the tree, you guys could be growing a firm foundation for yourself, like with you taking the time out to start this business, or like take your time out to go the extra mile. You're going to be setting some firm roots for yourself, because when we're talking about the tree, we're talking about a level of firmness. Okay, it takes time for a tree to grow. This is very specific too. If you're interested in getting into like real estate, or like maybe doing stuff with like flipping homes, this could be something that you're destined to do. And that's a very specific message, not for everyone. But not only that, I'm getting really good energy around like online businesses or potential earnings or online money. Some of you guys are destined to be doing something that you're running away from doing in this moment. And that's why every journey begins with a small step, maybe here. Okay, but let's move on. So we have the coffin, we have the mountain, and we also have the moon here. So, with the coffin, this represents endings. This would be like the death card in the regular tarot, okay? This is also about grief, letting go. Okay, negativity. Okay, needing to release, burying something. Okay, letting something subside. With the mountain card being right next to it and the moon. Yeah, some of you guys, you may have not known the full extent of how damaging it may have been for you to stay in a particular relationship, whether this is a friendship, you living with a family member. This is not limited to just love, but just know that you are definitely being protected by your spiritual team, especially from certain problems here. Okay. I feel like also any obstacles that you've been experiencing are just coming to an end, especially if you've been in a space of not knowing what's next with the moon card being here. Okay. You may not know what's next for you, but know that things are definitely shifting. Some of you guys also may be natural mediums. Okay. That's why you could find yourself like really drawn to, or not really drawn, but like you could almost hear that. That's a whole nother topic. You could hear voices of people who've passed. Okay, that got kind of deep. Anyways, so the next row, I have the anchor, the stork, and I also have the bird card here. And with the anchor, this represents stability, groundedness, things being long-lasting, settling in, the energy of things being more secure. Okay, also dependable energy. And with the stork here, this energy like fertility, because you know the stork usually comes around when someone's about to give birth. And then also with the birds, this is like taking off and spreading your wings and whatnot. But anywho, in combination, you could be needing to change a routine here. Okay. I'm also seeing just overall progress. I think this whole reading is talking about progress that either is untapped into or is already on its way to you if you've been doing the work, especially with the store card being here. Like this is progress, or whatever transition or shifts that you're experiencing is transitioning you into more of a stable energy. And then with the birds, now, okay, you do need to be careful of certain gossip. There could be certain people who keep in contact with you to tell your business to other people, or they just in general tell your business. You could also have a very hectic routine over the next couple of weeks because a business could be very busy. You could also just find that your nerves are settling down. Like if you've been experiencing severe anxiety, you will find yourself in a place of peace over the next couple of weeks. So just know that everything is working behind the scenes. Just allow your physical reality to catch up. But this is what I see. I hope this reading was helpful. If it was, definitely thumbs up the video and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one.